Hello students, today in this practical session we are going to do the experiment number 6, that is the study of maize grain. So like every experiment, here also you have to write all these points in your copy. First is aim, that is the study of specimens of germinating maize grain. Then requirements, procedure, observation and inference. So aim, already I have told you what you have to write. Every points you will get in your practical book, which you can write in your practical copy, practical notebook. So next is the point, that is the requirements. Specimen of maize grain, razor to cut the grain into two equal halves, petri dish, glass slide, watch glass, hand lens and dissecting needle. Next we are going to discuss the procedure. At first, to see the parts of maize grain, we have to soak some maize grains in water for about 24 hours. Then you can study the grain externally and also internally by cutting the grain into two equal halves through the vertical plane. Then you have to draw the diagram and note the features, both the external features and the internal features. Now in the observation part, I have told you already, external and internal, both the features you have to write separately in your notebook. So first is external features in the observation category, in the observation part. So what are the external features? You can see this is the external diagram of the maize grain. So here you can see the maize grain is mainly conical and flattened. It shows two color differentiated regions, yellowish and whitish. Very easily you can differentiate the full grain into two parts. One is dark yellow in color, another one is whitish. Yellow colored part, you can see that is a broader part. Broader part is yellowish in color. That mainly contains endosperm. You can see here endosperm, broad yellowish part, that is the main endospermic part containing endosperm. And white colored part, that is the conical shaped part, that region mainly contains the embryo, this part, full embryo part. So yellowish broader part mainly contains endosperm region, and this part, whitish part, contains embryo. Now after cutting into two equal halves, you can see the internal structure of the maize grain. Now I am telling you once why it is known as grain, because here seed coat and fruit wall both are fused together, so that's why it is known as grain. So here you can see outer covering, that is the seed coat and fruit wall, both are fused together. Then already I have told you that the broader part mainly consists of endosperm. Endosperm is the part where the nutrients are stored for embryo during germination. Then this part, that is the embryo part, which contains scutellum, that is the single cotyledon, because maize grain is monocot seed, monocotyledonous seed, means it contains single cotyledon. So here you can see that is the single cotyledon part here, that is known as scutellum. So scutellum is the single cotyledon present below the endosperm in the maize grain. Now the embryo part also consists of plumule, that is the future shoot part, and the radical, that is the future root part. Plumule is covered by the coleoptile, that is the protective covering of plumule, and radical is covered by coleorhiza, that is the protective covering of radical. And you can see here one layer is present, aleuron layer, that covers mainly the endosperm part, aleuron layer. This aleuron layer mainly consists of the cells which are capable of producing enzymes that are required during germination. Very important enzymes that are producing. Okay, so now we can see the structures of maize grain externally and internally practically. So students, here you can see the external structure of a soaked maize grain. Already I have told you that externally, if you will observe a maize grain, soaked maize grain, you can see that broader part is yellowish in color, and the conical shaped part, that is the lower part, mainly whitish in color. So here you can see the color differentiation. Broader part you can see yellowish, and this part you can see that is the whitish. And this part, this yellowish part, mainly this yellowish part consists of endosperm, and this whitish part, that mainly consists of embryo in which single cotyledon or scutellum is present, and plumule, radical, all are present. And from outside, the maize grain is covered by a thin hard covering, that is mainly the fused fruit wall and seed coat, this one outside covering. Now if we will cut the seed into two equal halves through vertical plane, we can see this structure. Okay, this structure. So already I have taken out some seed coat, this part seed coat, you can see full covering. This is not only seed coat, actually it is the outer covering of maize grain, consists of fused fruit wall and seed coat, thin hard covering, covering full maize grain. Now you can see that this part, this full part, 3/4 part of the maize grain consists of endosperm, and this part mainly small part, lower one, this part is embryo part, which contains single cotyledon scutellum, and this small part you can see, this one, this is the embryo part, consists of plumule upper part, and lower part is radical.
So plumule is covered by protective covering coleoptile, and radicle is covered by protective covering coleorrhiza. So this part is the embryo part, whitish part, and this yellowish part is the endosperm part. Endosperm part is covered by the aleurone layer, and full maize grain is covered by the fused fruit wall and seed coat. So students, today we have studied the external and internal structure of maize grain. You write all the points in your notebook properly and draw the diagram in the white page. Okay, bye, and have a nice day.